different. I'm not reviewing a car. We're going to be fitting an intercooler on 2012 BMW 320 F30 diesel. So I'm going to show you step by step how to fit one on. So right now I'm on my way to pick one up for my client. It's the same procedure for a 1 series, 3 series, 4 series, and I'm sure it's the same for a petrol engine. Stay tuned, you can see. Okay, here's the old intercooler. It's a Valeo intercooler. As you can see, the rubber seal broke off. It's leaking air from this gap here, so it's not holding in any pressure. So I'm picking up the new intercooler now. Here's the intercooler. It's a Valeo intercooler, Valeo making for BMW. Here's the key for the car. Here's the car. Okay, I'm not going to be putting the car inside the garage as I don't have enough room right now, because I've got other jobs in. So I'm going to do it outside. You need a jack. Okay, I've already jacked it up. The car's on the jacking point. Axle stands on this side here. I've already removed the engine tray. So you need an 8mm socket with a ratchet and an extension if you need one. A flat screwdriver to take off the clip on the intercooler pipes. A Torx, which is for the intercooler. Torx will be one torque there and one torque on the other side. The torque is a 25 Torx. You need a light so you can see, and some maintenance spray. I've already removed the old intercooler, so I'll show you how to remove it and put one back on. Okay, I'm underneath the car. The intercooler, the screw, the two Torx screws, one's here, one's on the other side, which go into the housing for the rad and the AC. Okay, you will get, this is the intercooler pipe. This is the same on the opposite side. This clip here, this one here, that goes into the actual intercooler housing. So what you need to do is, you need to get a flat screwdriver and take it completely off. I've got my camera in my hand, so basically like that. So now that clip's not there, as you can see. So if I let go, there you go, you'll see that clip again. Okay, simple as that. And basically the intercooler slides in and out. Here's the grooves for it. There's one there, there's one there. Simple. Okay, now I'm gonna fit this one on and I'll show you how it looks. As you can see, here's the new intercooler, it's fitted in. Okay, always check that you fit it on the pipe correctly. Once you fit the pipe on top of the intercooler, the clip will click into place and you'll hear a click. Torx screws that I was on about, there's one here and there's one on this side. So don't over tighten them, because you'll end up damaging the housing. So I've got the final one to do, I'll do it on camera. This one here is a 25 Torx, it might be different on your car. There you go, that's tight enough. As you can see, it's screwed in. Don't want to tighten it more than that. And it's sitting here correctly. And on this side here. There you go, job well done. Get this car fired up and back to the customer. Fitted everything back on correctly. Intercooler's on, engine tray's on. Jack's down. So now it's the final checks. Gonna switch on the car, check if the engine light's on. If it's on, we'll have to switch it off with the diagnostics machine. Take the vehicle on a test drive, and after that we can finally return the vehicle. I've just come back from a test drive. The vehicle drives great. Engine light's off. Now it's time to return the vehicle back to its customer. If you've liked this video, give it a thumbs up. Hit the subscribe button and leave a comment below. I'll see you guys in some more videos soon.